If any of you watched 60 Minutes a couple of weeks ago, I think Bob Simon, who I believe is Jewish, had a piece about the exodus of Christians from Bethlehem and from the Holy Land. And he pretty much blamed Israel for what is happening, that their regulations and their strictures were causing these Palestinian Christians to leave. Well, Israel is the birthplace of Christianity, and now many parts of that land are under Arab control. And many Christians, as I say, are fleeing. Andrea Garrett has that story.
It could be described as a modern-day exodus. Christians leaving Palestinian Arab-controlled areas like Bethlehem in great numbers.
My prediction that if the remaining Christians in the West Bank and Gaza, Gaza only has maybe 1,000 or 2,000 Christians. If their needs are not addressed in 10 or 15 or at most 20 years, there won't be any Christians. In the cradle of Christianity, this will be a kind of memorial, a museum.
Threat of persecution, including beatings and forced marriages between Christian women and Muslim men, are some of the reasons Christians have left. Although the economy and tourism picked up last year, uncertainty still prevails.
I know if you just look deep within their hearts, I know many people have fear and doubt in the unknown and unseen.
Pastor Steve Khoury leads churches in Bethlehem and in Jerusalem. Part of their outreach includes Christmas banquets each year, sponsored in part by CBN. Khoury says they do many unorthodox things to bring the message that hope is only built on the solid rock of Jesus Christ.
Well, Pastor Steve has come from Bethlehem. He's joining us right now on the 700 Club. And Steve, it's good to have you with us. God bless you. Welcome.
Thank you, Brother Pat. It's good to be here.
All right, you've got a church in Bethlehem. Now, look, we just saw 60 Minutes saying the Israelis are responsible for the exodus of Christians from Bethlehem. True or false?
Well, brother, Israel is not the full ultimate reason why Christians are fleeing. I always say maybe some of the policies that are placed there for the extremists. Christians are suffering partially because of that, but Christians are leaving because they are seeing nobody standing with them. They're seeing that extremism is growing, anti-Christian agenda is growing, and that's why they're leaving. That is the truth.
Well, Bethlehem was, I mean, I remember Elias Frage, and I met some years ago. He was a Christian. He's the mayor of Bethlehem. Bethlehem was a Christian city. What happened?
Well, Brother Pat, over the years, so much has happened. You have the Intifada, the first, second Intifada. Then you have, of course, some of the barriers that have gone around the city of Bethlehem, which wasn't put there to target Christians, mm-hmm. but has affected them economically. It has affected them from a political standard. You know, the Christians look around and they realize we're all alone. We're just being pressured in this area when nobody's looking out for us. And many of them have chosen to leave. More than 5,000 have fled. This is even the minimum mm-hmm. have fled in the past 10 years.
Well, what do you see with your church? Are you bringing Muslims to the Lord? Are you bringing Jews to the Lord? Or are they, just the indigenous Christians?
Well, Brother Pat, you know, I want to take you back. When I was age 16 years of age, a young man came to us who's from another religion, who's extremist religion his family's from, and he came to us to be discipled. And I remember my father told me, I want you to disciple him. I began to disciple him. 2.5 weeks later, he disappeared. And I didn't know what was going on. I didn't know what happened, but I realized that the Arabic Bible I gave him, his mom found under his bed. So for 3 days, his uncles, every 5-6 hours, they would come in, they would attack him, they would beat him up to deny Jesus, not one single time did he deny Jesus Christ. So they turned their attention, the uncles, from him to my life. And I remember I was walking down the church street at age 16 towards our church in Bethlehem, and I was attacked by 7 men. They had chains in their hands and wooden sticks in their hands. And as they put me to the ground, they beat me up because I was faithful enough to share my faith. And apparently the message I shared with this young man, it touched his heart. And by that beating that I got, what it did to me is it made my love for Jesus even stronger. Mm-hmm. And what beating did to me is made me realize how real Jesus Christ is. And they were thinking by beating me up or attacking me, they would shelter my faith or shake my faith. But all it did is made my love mm-hmm. for Jesus even stronger. It made me realize that Israel needs somebody like me. The Bethlehem territories need somebody like myself and my father to share the gospel.
Do those men think that's part of their faith to beat up Christians, that they would intimidate Christians so that they would deny Jesus? Is that the idea?
Unfortunately, a lot of people's mindsets who are considered to be jihadists or extremists, that is the ultimate goal, is to put fear and submission in the heart of every single Christian in the Middle East.
And they're pretty effective in doing that, aren't
yes,
they?
Unfortunately, they are. I mean, you have our church in Jerusalem. My father started the church in Bethlehem. My father was on the show with you back in 1996. He has a church in Bethlehem, and we have seven ministries. But one of our churches in Jerusalem, Brother Pat, you know, we're getting so much pressure. We've been kicked out of three church buildings in Jerusalem. In the East Jerusalem, in the Arab side, because it's on the Israeli territories, but it's in the Arab neighborhoods. In the Arab neighborhoods, you're sort of on your own. You know, if you call in Israel to help, you're a traitor. So we're sort of in our own. We've been kicked out of three church buildings in Jerusalem, and right now nobody's wanting to rent us a church building. So we're stuck within less than 8 months to be in a church in Jerusalem with no building. And the ultimate goal in Jerusalem is to see every evangelical church shut down. That is the mentality that's going on, but our heart's desire is to see a church in Jerusalem.
Are your parishioners afraid?
You know, there are some concerns, but my message to them is to be bold for Jesus. And Jesus says they will persecute you because they have persecuted me before you. That's Christ's promise to us, that they will persecute you.
Here in America, we find that hard to believe, that somebody would be beat up and persecuted on account of his faith, but that's standard procedure.
Well, it is. In Christianity, you are made to be a person that suffers for Christ. I mean, it's part of who we are, Brother Pat. And, you know, there's a lot of good Jewish people. There's a lot of good Muslims that don't know their Quran, but the less they know, the better Muslims they are. Yeah. We have a lot. I grew up with Muslims. I grew up with Jewish people that just want peace, want love. And unfortunately, Satan sort of grabs the hearts of those extremists to take everything to the next level. And that's why America's suffering as it is. It's because it's against the message. It's Antichrist spirit that we are dealing with right now. And we are praying for the peace of Jerusalem. And, you know, I love the verse in Proverbs. You know, trust in the Lord with all thy ways. You know, lean not unto your own understanding. And all thy ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct thy path.
Well, you're a very courageous person. I want to ask you one more question. We have textbooks in America that say that Sharia law teaches Muslims that they should be tolerant of Jews and Christians and help them. Is that true?
Well, in the first book in the Quran, after the opening, it's called Picture of the Cow. The Picture of a Cow, it was in the Quran, some of the writings of Muhammad. And in there, he talks about the struggle the Jewish people go through and the struggle the Christians go through. And as he shares the story of the Jewish people coming out of exile, and he shares the story of Christians believing in Jesus Christ, his writing as a storyline becomes emotionally attached, where he starts to condemn both the Jewish and the Christian people. And his condemnation of them, he condemns the Jewish people for betraying God. And after all that God has done to you, how dare you do 1, 2, 3, how dare you worship God in a calf? And then he goes on to the Christians and says, how dare you worship a man? Jesus came to be the prophet to tell you of the one Father, the one God, and you turn him into God. So his storyline of becoming, sharing history, becomes emotionally involved, where he starts to condemn them. So to some extent, there is a lot of teachings against that aspect as well.
Well, does he teach his followers to attack churches and attack Christians?
Well, you know, he does teach them to be jihadists. He does teach them to fight for what they believe in. He does teach them. In the Quran, does say next to every church, build a mosque. He does say that. Mm-hmm. So he does teach them to be jihadists. He teaches them to fight for their cause, for their faith, at any cost and every cost. So we see a lot of violence in the Quran. But, you know, Muslims would come to us and say there's a lot of violence in the Old Testament as well. And the two differences are is that in the Bible, people were fighting for what they believe in. In other religion, other faith, and other jihadism, people are fighting against people for what they believe in. That's the two different aspects that we have.
Steve, thank you very much. Pastor Steve Khoury, ladies and gentlemen, pray for him. Courageous people suffering for their faith in the city of Bethlehem, the place where Jesus Christ was born.